dear friends, I'd just like to give a very brief synopsis of the Christmas musical entitled A Christmas Carol. Let me just have an indication by show of hands. There are four answers possible. Just put up your hands once. I wonder if you have a child or a grandchild, at what age would you consider it appropriate to give them a smartphone? First choice, under 12 years old. Second choice, between 12 and 15. Third choice, between 15 and 18. And fourth choice, above 18. Let's call it A, B, C, and D. Let's have a quick indication by show of hands. How many of you say A, under 12 years old? Put up your hands. How many of you say B, 12 to 15 years old? Put up your hands. How many of you say C, 15 to 18 years old? Put up your hands. And how many of you say D, above 18 years old? Put up your hands. And how many of you say never give them any? Put up your hands. Okay, now that's interesting to know. Now today's story focuses on a boy called Kevin. Kevin is a typical 21st century boy, very well connected with his loving family, as well with a loving church, and particularly the children's choir. The children's choir, they have a project of raising money for the orphanage. Kevin has a dilemma to face, either part with his money and give it to the orphanage, or to buy his perfect Christmas presents. Initially, Kevin's conscience and spirit, they are not quite affected by that choice, despite the forceful persuasion of one or two of his family members. But lo and behold, suddenly there comes divine persuasion. Now, before I vanish from the stage, I'd just like to say this for regular church members. There are actually video clips that are part of the musical for today, and they depict the past, present, and future. Now, later when you see the video clip, there's a little boy called Timmy. And Timmy is actually Caden, as you some of us know him. Now, when Timmy grows older, he becomes Dr. Lim Easer. And when he grows even older, he becomes Jimmy Ng, okay? Now, you may not be able to pick that up, that's why I told it to you right now. And also, we have our Orang Asli child, Ephesus, and when he becomes older, he becomes Johanan. So, without much ado, let's welcome the Christmas Carol.
Thank you. Wow, cool! Grandma sent me a check for 200 ringgit!
Good for you, Kevin. What a nice gift.
She says in her letter that this is for all the odd jobs I did for her during the semester break. And I know just how I'm going to spend it. You know the Samsung Galaxy smartphone in the Aeon Mall?
You mean the one that costs 400 ringgit?
Yep, that's the one. With this 200 ringgit and the money I have saved, I can buy that phone as a Christmas present to myself. I can just see it now. There I am, Kevin Lee, with the Samsung Galaxy smartphone in the palm of my hand. Yep, with this money, it's a done deal.
No time to dream on, Kevin. We have to hurry off to choir practice. I'll cash this check for you. Where are your sister and brother? Lauren? Jonathan? Come on. You've got to get to choir practice.
Hurry in, everyone. This is our last rehearsal before the Christmas service. We've got to make sure we are ready.
You see.
Sisters, like all of you have to celebrate Christmas with.
I'm always glad to give to those who need.
What about you, Kevin? Something you can give?
I'm sorry, everyone. I really wanted to help the orphans, but it seems my funds are a little tied up. Maybe next year.
That's quite okay, Kevin. That's okay. But if we can, we need to give to those who are in need, whether it is money, encouragement, friendship or love. And every time we give to someone, we are really helping Jesus and his mission on earth. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 10, each one should use whatever gift he has received to serve others. Well, I guess you could say, we need to give it up for Jesus.
Give it up, give it up, come on and give it up, give it up, give it up for Jesus. Let it ring, let it ring, come on and let it sing. Give it up for Jesus. Give it up, come on and give it up, give it up for Jesus. You can share, give to others, show you care, sing the wicked.
is here. Bye-bye. Okay. I see you all tomorrow. Now, don't be late, okay? And remember to collect as much money as you can for the orphanage. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hello? Wake up! friends?
I don't have any friends who look like you.
Well, then let me introduce myself. I'm Hark. Hark the Herald Angel. And these are my sisters, Peggy Sue, Tomora, and Emma. And this is our angel team.
How did you get in here?
Oh, we angels have our ways.
Maybe I'd better go get my mom and dad.
Oh no, that won't be necessary. Not necessary at all. We are under strict instructions from our boss. He told us that someone here is in need of some heavenly help. And that someone is named Kevin.
Well, I'm Kevin Lee.
Nice to meet you, Kevin.
Cool, it's just super fun to be here.
I'm so glad to meet you, Kevin.
Awesome, it's just great to be with you.
Hey, these are some awesome angel outfits.
I'm Peggy Sue, and I'm a blast from the past, ready to bring you a big newsflash.
And I, Emma, will help bring you up to date. I specialize in what you could call current events.
I'm Tamora. I'm here to help you see what is to come. I have a great view of the horizon.
But most importantly, we announce the good news of Jesus. He is born. Our Savior is born. Girls, we need to get down to business. Have a seat. Hey, Matt, don't look so nervous. Relax. It says here that your choir is raising some money for a Christmas gift to an orphanage. Is that true?
Well, yes, but it seems my funds are kind of tied up. I'll give a big Christmas gift next year.
Christmas gift? That reminds me of the very first Christmas gift. That glorious night in Bethlehem, when the best gift of all came down on earth. The best gift was not money, not a toy, and not a smartphone. In fact, the best gift of all was a baby, Jesus.
What a gorgeous baby.
Totally awesome.
The greatest baby of all time.
You're right, Emma. Jesus was and is the greatest baby of all time. You know, that night in the fields near Bethlehem, some shepherds were watching their sheep. All at once, an angel of the Lord came down to them, and the Lord's glory flashed around them. The shepherds were frightened. But the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will make everyone happy. Today, in the town of David, a Savior is born to you. He is Christ the Lord." In fact, I remember it as if it were just yesterday. By dying on the cross for all their sins.
Just think, Eternal tomorrow with Jesus.
What a super idea! It would be just awesome!
But the gift you give to Jesus is also important.
My gift? You're forgetting. I told you my funds are a little tied up. Anyway, I don't see why my gift is so important. I'm just a kid!
There have been many times in the past, Kevin, that God has used a gift given by ordinary people like you and made it into something wonderful. Peggy Sue, our angel of the past, can tell us more.
Let me give you some yesterday wisdom, Kevin. God is your Heavenly Father who loves you perfectly, whether you are good or bad. This is the Father heart of God. Absolutely! To show you His unconditional love, Father God sent Jesus down into the world. Jesus coming down to earth was truly the best gift of all. And with Him came something wonderful.
Hope!
Yes, hope! Because of the Father heart of God. In Romans chapter 15, verse 4, the scripture says, everything that was written in the past was written to teach us. The scriptures give us patience and encouragement so that we can have hope. Hope for tomorrow and hope for today. It's just super what a gift from the past can do.
You gotta have hope, hope, hope. You gotta have hope, hope.
a church nearby that collected an offering to bless the community at Christmas. With the offering collected, they brought gifts for the children in the orphanage. A couple from the church brought the gifts. And they saw little Timmy and felt that God wanted them to give him a loving home. So they adopted him. Through their love for him, Timmy came to understand how much Father God loved him, and he accepted Jesus as his Savior and Lord. And as you will see, this gift of a loving home to Timmy and the message of the Father heart of God changed him forever.
I know what you're saying is true, Peggy Sue, but that was then and this is now. What can a kid like me really do today?
Aha! Emma, our angel of the present, can help you, Kevin.
I would love to, Hark. The Bible says in Psalm 118, verse 24, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad today." Remember, every day is a gift from God. That's why they call it the present.
The days are passing one by one, as quickly as the wind. The awful vision with a day, we write it all to end. But every day our Lord creates, has purpose big and bold. The day to share His message sweet, we want the world to know.
Timmy demonstrates to his children the gift of love that comes from the Father heart of God in the way he loves and nurtures them.
I see what you mean, Emma. The gift of the loving one to Timmy, made so long ago, is still working today.
Now you're getting the picture, Kevin. And tomorrow, the gift will keep on going. You see, anything that Jesus touches will grow today, tomorrow, and forever.
Did someone say with you?
Tomorrow, you're the angel of the future. You bring us news of what is to come. What can you share with us?
Knowing about the future will be so cool. What will I be like? What will I look like? Where will I live?
Only our Lord knows the future. But we do know our tomorrows with Jesus will be wonderful. Father God wants us to share Jesus and His love to the people around us.
Indeed, He wants each of us to do it.
In Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 and 20, Jesus said, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age."
Jesus will be with us both now and forever.
Our future will be an eternal life with Jesus, the Lamb of God.
Of those from every tribe and tongue.
December, years from now on. Timmy is getting older. His children are all grown up, and two of them have families of their own. They love and nurture their own children in the way they learned from their father. Throughout his life, Timmy has shared Jesus and the love of Father God with many people. Timmy is growing old though. You might think his time of helping others is drawing to a close, but you would be wrong. Timmy goes to an Orang Asli village once every 3 weeks and shares with the Orang Asli people the gift of Jesus and the Father heart of God. You see? The gift just keeps on going, and going,
and going,
and going,
and going.
You see, Kevin, one little gift can make a difference, whether it is giving our money, our time, or investing our lives in the lives of others. We are actually giving to Jesus, and that brings His blessings to those we bless, and also to us. Jesus loves and blesses a cheerful giver. Now, we must be on our way.
Don't leave! You guys are so cool! I want you to meet my family!
No, our mission with you has ended, Kevin. But remember to seek the guidance of our boss when making your decisions. He will lead you to what is right.
Dear Jesus, please give me the strength to give my gift to you. I am so weak. I want my way. Help me, dear Lord, to want your way. In your name I pray. Amen.
Kevin, rise and shine. It's Christmas Day. Let's come, wake up. We have got to get to church.
Mom, you won't believe what happened to me last night.
I want to hear all about it, Kevin. But right now, we are late. We have got to get to church. Let's stop on our way.
Mom, you was amazing! Right after you guys went to bed, there are these four angels that appeared in the living room. Their names were Ha, Peggy Sue,
everyone, that was wonderful. Now, it is almost time for our Christmas presentation. Rebecca, before we begin, what's the final count for our Christmas gift to the orphanage?
I can't believe it. We have over 500 ringgit to give to the orphanage this year. There are 2 100 ringgit notes. I think they are given by the one and same person.
Wow!
Praise God! Thanks to the person who gave so generously.
Kevin, you gave that money. That was all you had.
I didn't really need a smartphone.
I think you're the best big brother ever. Wow! Awesome, Kevin!
I gave because Father God gave me his best, Jesus!
God is a perfect Father, and being his child makes Christmas extra special.
This Christmas, look to the past and remember the Father heart of God, who showed his love to us through the gift of Jesus. Look to the present and realize that every day is a gift from God to use in His service to bless others. And finally, look to the future, realizing that we should pass on the gift of the Father heart of God to others. Give to Jesus this Christmas, and you will be blessed.
God blesses everyone.